Let's take a look at how to add our map to our final project poster template. You can see here I've made a couple changes to the template to better fit my project, but it's still the same size. It's still that 48 inches by 36 inches or whatever the final project size is. It's still quite a large size PowerPoint slide. So you can add in the, if you're not familiar working with PowerPoint or working in Google Slides, you can add in the ruler that you're seeing here that will give you an idea of how big all your elements are. You can add in the grid lines if you want to kind of give you an idea of where things are being placed. So let's say I've got my text in these two boxes, introduction, methods, analysis. Now I need to add my maps in for my results. So here I am with my 1986 land use map. Notice I'm in the layout view versus the data view. So on my layout view, I've added in all my map elements and I'm ready to export the map. To do that, I'll go to File, Export Map, and it's telling you export this map as PNG, EPS, JPEG, PDF, etc. The other important thing to remember, if you are in data view, your current map display and extent will be exported. If you are in layout view, which I am, your entire page layout will be exported. So if I export from data view, I will not get any of my north arrows, scale bars, legend, etc. You have to remember to export from your layout view. File, export map, and it's going to bring up the export map option. Actually, let me put this up here. So I will call it, we can save it probably as a PNG, so it'll give us a little bit more detail, or a JPEG. You can change the resolution if you wanted to. Just keep it the default for now, and we'll go ahead and click Save. Now I can go over to my PowerPoint slide and click on Insert Pictures from this device. I have to go under my folder where I saved it. Whoops. What do you think I saved it as? Let's see. Oh, you know what? Oh, I saved it in the main folder. There it is. So once I find the file, I go ahead and click Insert, and it'll add my map in. And you can resize it from here if you wanted it a little bit bigger. I've got to add in a second map, so I don't want it to be as large. If I wanted to add in a border, I could. You'll see that border being added. We can change the border color, the border weight, if you wanted to, etc. So that's how you would add in your map. Now remember, if you add in your JPEG or PNG and it is missing the title, missing the legend, missing north arrow, scale bar, that means you exported from your data frame. So make sure to go back to your data view. Make sure you go back to ArcMap, you change it to your layout view, and export from there. Let's say you wanted to add in a table of your area, or comparing something, you needed to add in a table. You can add in a table right onto the PowerPoint slide. Let's say we wanted to compare land uses. Oops, that's too many, but we can edit that. Land uses, so we'll say land use type. We'll say 1986, we'll say 2018. We'll get rid of this column, maybe. Delete the column. Okay. So this is right now, we can go over to our format and see that the size of this font is 86. That's why it's so large. So if you're worried when you add it to the map or add it to your PowerPoint slide and you're trying to get it resized, always check back at what that font size is. So since this is a table, it doesn't need to be, as large as the title, especially since some of that body text is going to be smaller. So you could add in from here, we got to change that size. Add in, what are some more land use types? Agriculture, residential, let's make that smaller, etc. And then you would add in your values. Now it may look really small to you, but remember this table is still, this first column for this table is almost 6 inches wide. So it's not, if we were to print this out, that 36 by 48, oh good, my computer's frozen, 36 by 48 size of paper, it would be, a decent size and people would be able to get close enough to read it. You also could save your table as an image and add it in that way too, if you create a table in a different program. So definitely pay attention to your size of your fonts, pay attention to the size of the poster. But the easiest way to add in your map and to add in other features onto your PowerPoint slide is to go to Insert Picture, or Insert Shapes, or Insert Table, whatever you want to add in.